One of the more common questions that I get in my mobile UX class is about tables. How do we make tables fit on a smartphone screen? Even though you may not realize it, this question has been around since way before mobile phones were so widespread. And in order to answer it, we should look back at the research in the field of information visualization. Why is this topic not specific to mobile? For the simple reason that since the dawn of tables, there have been tables that were too big for someone's screen. When I was working at Xerox PARC, I remember Stu Card, one of the human-computer interaction pioneers and fathers of information visualization, working on an array of 8 24-inch monitors. But even if you have 8 64-inch monitors, there will be a table that's too big even for that. And even if your table was displayable on such a huge screen, the person interacting with it will not have the working memory capacity to take in all that content. The most basic thing you can do to make tables more usable is fix columns and row headings, like in this example from Fidelity. This will ensure that people will know what cell they're looking at, even though they will have to scroll horizontally or vertically in order to get to that cell. Next, ask yourself, what are people trying to do with your table? Often, they will want to compare two rows or two columns. And that's not easy if those columns or rows don't fit on the same screen. Users would have to go to one cell, memorize its info, then move on to the other item in a different column or row and compare what they see there with what they can remember about the first item. So, to facilitate comparison, allow users to 1. Hide columns that are of little interest, 2. Reorder columns so they can see those they are interested in side by side. For this latter functionality, often drag and drop is the obvious implementation. But if the table is big, it can be difficult to drag a column in the right place across several screenfuls of information. That's why we recommend that for tables with many columns, you include a reorderable list view of all the column names. Similarly, let users hide certain rows by filtering out records that are less relevant for their task. Think about the types of filters that people will be interested in. For example, in a product comparison table, people are often interested only in rows that are different. So allowing them to hide the similarities can make the table smaller. So, if you're asking yourself, how can you display big tables with a limited screen real estate? The answer is, you cannot. Seeing the whole table on the screen is rarely relevant to the user's task. What designers need to do is carry out a thorough task analysis to understand what a task is, and then offer users the tools to complete it.